Running with wolves and I'm on the prowl.
She don't care, we like almost there, the right vibe. Ready to get live, ain't no surprise. Take me so high, jumping those dives, surfing the crowd. Ooh, said I gotta be the man, I'm the head of my band. Mic check, 1, 2. Shut them down in the club where the Playboy does. So they all get loose, loose, out the bottle. We all get fit in again tomorrow. Gotta break rules, cause that's the motto. Club shut down, 100 supermodels.
Hey, took your home and be a woman. Show me how you do. I wanna shut down in the club with you.
Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous George. Here it comes.
Pretty Glassy, the maker of
champions. Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a
place. Ladies and gentlemen, it is electric.
And this man.
You are fucking
the champ is here.
After months of anticipation, WrestleMania week is finally here. From the Eden Rock Hotel in gorgeous Miami, Florida, we are just moments away from the WrestleMania 28 press conference live on WWE.com, the first ever live WWE stream on YouTube, WWE.com, and Facebook. Hello, everyone. Josh Matthews with Matt Stryker. Matt, a great perspective for the WWE Universe moments before this press conference.
Well, the sun is shining and all the stars are here. Members of the Associated Press are here. ABC, NBC, CBS, Fox, the Miami Herald, the list goes on and on. They're all here to see WWE Champion CM Punk is in attendance. The lovely Eve Torres has just arrived. The man who will seek to end The Undertaker's undefeated streak at WrestleMania, Triple H, is here. Representatives of both Team Teddy and Team Johnny are here as well. And for the first time ever, the two superstars who will collide in a once-in-a-lifetime battle, both The Rock and John Cena, are here. WrestleMania is kicking off right now.
And you mentioned that members of Team Teddy and Team Johnny are here. We'll see them momentarily. The captains, David Otunga and Santino Marella. And, of course, everyone talking about the end of an era Hell in a Cell match. It's a trending topic almost every day between The Undertaker and Triple H, of course, a special guest referee.
WWE Hall of Famer and Triple H's best friend, Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, will be the special guest referee inside of Hell in a Cell. How does that factor into this matchup?
And recently, some WWE legends and WWE Hall of Famers sat down to discuss the end of an era Hell in a Cell match at WrestleMania.
A rematch for the ages. The Undertaker versus Triple H at WrestleMania 28. The end of an era.
Last year's match at WrestleMania, it was probably one of the greatest matches of all time.
It was unbelievable.
After the first match was so amazing, it almost made me wonder how they're going to be able to top what they did. You know, you add in Hell in a Cell and the stakes completely change.
Remember, it's Hell in a Cell.
Quite possibly the most brutal match that you can have in the WWE.
Anything can happen.
It's a whole different ballgame.
I don't think either one of them will ever be the same, but they're going to give you everything they've got.
If it's truly the end of an era, it will be interesting to see who is the lone survivor.
The Undertaker's streak of 19-0, it means everything to him. He will die before he's 19-1.
Whoever loses this, I don't know if you come back. I really don't.
Don't move your lips. Ring the bell.
Watch every second of this one, because when it's over, there'll never be another one like it. Ever.
It will truly be an end of an era this Sunday inside Hell in a Cell. Another match, Matt, that's on everyone's mind. Team Teddy versus Team Johnny. The stakes in this one couldn't be any higher for either John Laurinaitis or Theodore Long.
Well, if Team Johnny is victorious at WrestleMania, then John Laurinaitis will be in control of both Raw and SmackDown. But if Team Teddy prevails, then Teddy Long will be in charge. As you said, Josh, the stakes could not be higher at WrestleMania.
And I mentioned earlier that we would be joined by the captains of Team Teddy and Team Johnny. Right now, we are seeing Santino Marella, captain of Team Teddy. Santino, thank you for joining us. And David Otunga, the captain of Team Johnny. David, thank you for being here as well. Santino, I'll start with you. Why is Team Teddy going to be successful this Sunday?
Well, it's very simple. Justice. You see, we are the good guys. They are the bad guys. There's no mistake about that. And in the end, the good guys always perseverance.
David, Santino mentioned justice. Your rebuttal.
Well, it's not often that a buffoon such as Mr. Marella is correct. But yes, justice will prevail in this matchup because Team Johnny has the legal counsel, Mr. David Otunga, yours truly. Oh, you scoff. I am the smartest WWE superstar in history. Not to mention, they haven't seen a physique like this since Ravishing Rick Rude. I'm like a young Arnold Schwarzenegger in his prime. Nobody's going to beat my team.
Well, gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us. Good luck to both your respective teams this Sunday at WrestleMania. Will it be Team Teddy or Team Johnny? Who will control both Monday Night Raw and Friday Night SmackDown? Will it be John Laurinaitis or will it be Theodore Long?
Theodore Long is going to win. Why don't you go chase an ambulance somewhere?
We will find out Sunday at WrestleMania. And of course, Matt, yes. Another big time match at WrestleMania. Once in a lifetime, John Cena versus The Rock. I know you guys, Santino, I know you have an opinion on this. You want to weigh in?
This is one thing that I actually cannot predict. I weigh back and forth every day. I think about it. But every day I cannot come to a conclusion. Every day.
Santino Marella, it's tremendous. Thank you so much for your insight there to John Cena versus The Rock. Right now, let's take a look at how this all came about between John Cena and The Rock for their match at WrestleMania.
The Rock versus John Cena, WrestleMania 28.
The best part about all of this.
Two icons in their prime.
Me, John. And the fans.
It's once in a lifetime.
WrestleMania is like no other night.
We say it and it becomes cliched, but it's showcase of the immortals. Memories are made.
It's taken on a whole life of its own. It's become mythical even before it happens.
It is the grandest stage of them all.
Rock versus Cena, WrestleMania, once in a lifetime. Epic.
They are the biggest stars in this industry.
They have a desire to be the best.
They need success like they need air.
A desire to be in the spotlight.
And they will both put everything they have into getting that air.
Who needs to win more?
John Cena needs to win this match to validate that he is who he says he is.
Rock has to prove to the entire world that he still has what it takes.
These are two guys that are going to go out there and paint the ultimate masterpiece.
I think it's going to be one of the best matches that we've ever seen because it's destined to be that.
Once in a lifetime, John Cena and The Rock. I can't wait to hear what these two have to say live in a matter of moments at the WrestleMania 28 press conference.
Well, the thing about this match is that it's so polarizing. Everyone has an opinion, but the question is, when you're asked where were you when The Rock and John Cena collided at WrestleMania, what's going to be your answer? Are you going to miss this moment? I don't think you should.
And of course, as we await the WrestleMania 28 press conference live, South Beach, Miami, Matt has really opened up WWE. I mean, all week long, it's been a tremendous week so far.
WWE Access has taken over South Florida. It's a week-long festivities. Of course, the Hall of Fame. Everyone looking forward to the induction of Edge.
Hey!
Iron Mike Tyson will.
Whoa! How can you have a press conference in Miami without the most must-see WWE superstar in history? Without the man that main-evented WrestleMania 27 and retained his WWE championship not once, but twice? How can you have a press conference in Miami, Florida, without the man that is going to take Team Johnny to victory and basically going to make John Laurinaitis the most powerful man in sports entertainment? I'm going to make him the general manager of Raw and SmackDown.
Well, you were almost left off WrestleMania. I mean, you just
left
got...
Left off? Josh, are you kidding me? Are you left off? It was like the Peyton Manning sweepstakes in the WWE, and I was the Peyton Manning. I was the top talent. They were bidding war. There's a huge bidding war with Team Teddy and Team Johnny to get me, and that's why it took so long. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone.
You weren't rattled at all. You didn't think that I might not get to WrestleMania. I mean, for weeks you were sort of on edge that you weren't going to make it to WrestleMania.
Josh, there is no WrestleMania 28 without The Miz. Let's just face it. WrestleMania 27 was all about The Miz. The only thing anybody could talk about was The Miz. And then you went to WrestleMania 28, and I guarantee you this, the only thing anyone's going to be talking about after on Monday Night Raw is The Miz. They're not going to be talking about John Cena and The Rock, Triple H, HBK, Undertaker. They're going to be talking about the most must-see WWE champion of all time, The Miz.
Well, Miz, thank you very much for joining us. I'm getting word right now that the WrestleMania 28 press conference is about to start right now, live. Michael Cole's taking his place at the podium.
I pass my picket fence and gaze across my new mowed lawn. I never thought.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the WrestleMania 28 press conference. I'm Michael Cole, and we are live today on the shores of the Atlantic Ocean here in Miami Beach at the beautiful Eden Rock Hotel. We'd like to remind the members of the media that immediately following the events today, we are going to give you the opportunity to talk to our superstars one-on-one as they get ready for WrestleMania. I'd also like to welcome the